Hi everyone, this is Krishna Vandanapu, a business applications MVP. Welcome to my channel. In today's video, we will discuss about how to reduce loops with expressions in Power Automate. I logged on to Power Automate Maker portal. The first scenario I want to cover here is get items from data source. In this scenario, what I want to do is I want to get one record from my data source and send the details of that record to a specific user in an email. For this example, I'm taking SharePoint as a data source. In my SharePoint, I have a list called release management with a view called get lead details. And in this, I have a couple of release management records. Now, what I want to do is I want to get the record where the ID 2464 and send these details to Krishna. Let us see how it behaves if I don't use expression to get the details from a single record out of a get items. I'm selecting SharePoint. Get items is my action. I went ahead and selected my SharePoint site and the list name. Now I want to filter my data where ID equal to 2464. How I can do that is using filter query. ID equal to 2464. I know I have only one record in my database or the data source. I am expecting only one record out of it. Now I'm adding a compose and then I'm going to show the output of this get items in a compose statement. Let us see how the data will come in. Also, I have added send email action to send the email to Krishna. So I have selected Krishna, also mentioned my subject as ID 2464 release details. As part of the body, I want to mention all the release details as what is my project name. Now I'm selecting the project name to show as part of my email body. The time I select project name, there you go. It added a for each loop, though I don't need it because I know I'm going to get one record. Even on top of one record, it added a loop. Let us see why it added and how to avoid it. If I run this flow, I'm just copying the output of this and placing into Visual Studio Code. If I examine the output, it is showing the status code as 200, which is success. And if you see the body is having an array of records because it is sending array as my result set. And in the result, if you notice, I have ID only one time because I'm getting only one record. Since it is coming, the result is coming in an array, I am getting the for loop by default as and when I select my project name. But I don't want to see the for each loop because I don't want to add unnecessary actions as part of my Power Automate because each action is a API call. If I go to the service limits under aka.ms and if I see here, they have clearly mentioned that request limits based on user licenses. If I have only Power Automate per user plan, I have only 5000 API calls per day. If I do not monitor on my actions in my Power Automate flow, each and every action is a API call. So I have to be very careful while I am iterating through my data. If I know that I'm going to get only one record, I should write my flow effectively to avoid this loop. So how I can do that is I can avoid this with the help of expressions. Let me add another compose here to see how I can get only project name without having a loop with the help of expressions. So select this and go to expressions. Under expressions, what I have to do is outputs. I am going to write the formula as outputs of get underscore items question body slash value zeroth record because I have only one record. Under that I am getting the title, which is my project name. How do I know that is if you examine your JSON has body. Under body, I have value. JSON has only one record. So body slash value is going to take that record. Under that record, I have an array. So Since I have the array, I'm going to say which record, which element of the array I want. I am looking for 0th element of the array. Under that, what I want to do get is the title, which is the project name. So that is the exact formula I have written here. Now, if I say OK, it will automatically apply my formula as part of the compose. Now, I will test this flow and see whether I get my project name as part of compose 2 or not. The flow got run successfully. If I see the output, I got the output as sample. And if I go to my SharePoint list, 2464 project name is sample. So with the help of expression, I'm able to get the value without any loops. And it is very clear also. I got the one record and my data is only one. When you notice here, while I'm writing the expression, it is very hard how the expression is laid out with the help of the classic expression editor. How I can get rid of this confusion is by enabling the modern expression editor. How I can enable the modern editor is by clicking on the gear icon, click on view all Power Automate settings, enable the toggle and say save. This will reload the flow and enable modern editor for your Power Automate flow. If you see here now, the entire behavior will go change. Now if I select this, it will show the formula in the modern editor, and now it is very handy to read. Also, if I need to change, it is very handy. I can change whatever the way I want. Now that I know how I can get without a loop, let me get this email action out of my loop. But just select and drag and drop, and I remove this for each loop. As part of the email body, I'm going to write the very same expression what I have used as part of my compose. I'll say select here and click on the function. Use the same formula to get the project name. If I want to get the module name, I'll say the same formula I can use. All I need to do is I need to change the SharePoint column name, which I wanted to show as part of this. Now I want to show the team lead name also. If you see the JSON, team lead is not a single line of text and it is not a plain data. It is a people picker column. So always people picker column will come as a record. As we have seen last time, when we want to get the data from a record, like the way how we have written body slash value, here also what I will do, team lead slash which property of this record I wanted to get. In this scenario, I want to get display name. So what I have to write is the same formula. Here I'll say team lead slash display name. Let us run this flow and see how the output of the email. The flow ran successfully. Let me go on to Outlook. And if I notice here, the flow has sent the details very neatly, saying like, you know, project name as sample, module name as sample, and team lead as Sai Prithvinath Vandanapu. Here the team lead is Sai Prithvinath Vandanapu, project name, module name. This is how I can avoid unnecessary loops in my Power Automate with the help of expressions. And the same way I can apply for get files action. Also the same pattern, the expression pattern, I can apply for even to Dataverse database also. There is no change. The same thing. All you need to do is apply the expression appropriately to get the data. The second most common scenario we see this unnecessary looping is single level approval flow. When we are creating an approval flow with the single level approver and I want to read the comments of the approval or rejection, the flow will add the loop automatically, though it is not needed. Let us see what I mean exactly. I am going to add a approval flow, select the approvals. Under this, if you see create an approval, it will create an approval, and again we need to add another action to wait for the approval. But in this scenario, I'm taking start and wait for an approval action, and I'm going to select first to respond. As and when I select the action, it will ask you what is the title of your approval email and whom you want to assign. I'm going to say that testing for avoid looping, and here I'm going to assign it to myself. I mentioned that details as please provide comments. And now the next step, what we do is we will see what is the outcome of my approval flow. So in this, we will add a condition. As part of the condition, we'll say outcomes. If the outcome is approved, then I want to send the email to another user with the approval comment. Now let me say compose, and I want to see the user comments as part of my approval. I'll say select and say comments, response comments. The time I select responses comment, it added a loop here, correct? Now I'm saving this, I'm testing the flow. It went ahead and sent the email, approval email to Krishna. If you notice here, this approval can be done at various levels. One is from the Outlook, and another one is under action items. There is another option as approvals. When I go to here, user can approve from here as well. This is second way. And the third way is it sends a message on top of Teams as like this. It triggers an alert. When I click on this specific alert, it will show the approval request with the comments. Remember, doesn't matter user approve from which location. When user approve from one location, from all the other areas, this approval request will disappear. Now I'm saying that approving from Teams, I'll say approve. The time I approve, it got approved. And if I go to my approvals as part of the flow, it got disappeared because I approved already. And when I come to here, just say refresh my Outlook, just select the action, it automatically says that you have already completed this request. So I can approve this approval request from any one of these three channels. Now if I go back to my flow, the flow got completed. If I go and see the outcome of this flow and examine the output of this body, it is a array. Within the array, I have all my details. If you see, user commands is a response. Under the response, I have all the details. Approval response is approve, and comments as approving from Teams. So that is the reason it is adding a loop when I'm trying to get the response from my approval comments. Now, if I want to avoid that, again, the same logic, there is nothing different. I'm going to add a compose here. Under compose, I'm going to say expression function. Now this time, what I need to do, I need to get the response from the user, whatever the response they provided. In order to get that response, the expression for that is click on function. Now, if you see the JSON, the responses is in an array under the responses. Now search for responses and select all the responses. Now it is an array, the zeroth location of that first element of the array, and then I need to get comments out of it. Now if I run the flow with this expression without using loop, I will be able to get the comments which user has provided. When I test this, this time I'm approving this approval flow from Outlook. Click on approve. I'm saying like approving from Outlook, submit. If I go and check my flow, the flow got completed successfully. And if I see the condition, I'm able to get the data of the user comments without using my loop. With the help of this expression, I can get all the other details. If you notice the expression one more time, this is outputs of whatever the flow we have initiated. If you see, the approval flow is start and wait for approval, which is the same thing. I'm getting output of that, and the body slash responses. In that responses, zeroth location comments is the one I'm getting out of it. This is how I can avoid unnecessary actions in my flow, and I can leverage my API calls. I hope this helps you when you are planning for a larger flows. This is my contact information. If you like and enjoy the video, add your comments, subscribe to my YouTube channel for all future notifications. Post your questions as part of comments, or you can reach me on Twitter or LinkedIn. I can answer all your questions. Have a nice day. Thank you.